365 days and oodles of teardowns. We got the inside scoop on the insides of your favorite tech, with surprises and frustrations. Here are iFixit's top 5 teardowns of 2023. Starting things off with my 5th favorite teardown, the iPhone 15. I never expected an iPhone to make it to my top teardowns list, even one with USB-C. But with help from Evidence Scientific, we got some of the coolest views we've seen yet. The dynamic island pixels are impressively crisp and deserve the up-close look. That arrangement of LEDs is phenomenal to see up close. We also took a look at the Quest 3 screens as well. Cheaper LCDs, but still fun to look at. And we got a little aggressive on the Titanium Pro Max, and boy did it fold under pressure. You're better off sticking with good old steel and aluminum, in my opinion, both for environmental and aesthetic reasons. My favorite teardowns aren't just about repairable hardware. Fave teardown number 4 is the 2023 Mac Pro. And yeah, okay. I picked this one because I got away with grating 4 different cheeses on a multi-$1,000 computer. Man, I still think about how that thing grated Parmesan. And yes, it's still truly impressive to see Apple engineering applied to spacious PC cases. The slick levers and cable management are things of beauty. And it makes you wonder what Apple might accomplish if they weren't so obsessed with controlling the customer experience. I mean, look at this lovely heatsink. Okay, and yeah, the expansion opportunities are nice too. It's good to see that Apple doesn't make all of our hardware decisions for us, but I'm still dubious about the loss of modular RAM. Okay, the Vive XR Elite is my favorite VR hardware, spoiler alert, but the Quest 3 was such a bizarre creature I had to add it to my list at number 3. Pancake lenses from the Pro, and a time-of-flight sensor the Pro didn't have, makes this a bit of a mystery. This half-price amateur seems to be pretty pro to me. And to make things even more bizarre, the Pro has room for the sensor. Not just a sensor, but this very sensor in this exact configuration. Did manufacturing delays prevent the time of flight from getting into the Pro? Did they reserve it for the 3 to goose sales? Is the Quest 3 doing beta testing they didn't want to risk in the pricier model? I don't know, but I love some good conjecture, especially from a hardware team that seems to be almost as obsessive as Apple about aesthetics. And hidden batteries. Okay, you saw this coming, but my almost favorite teardown of the year is the Vive XR Elite, coming in at number 2. It was just so tickled to find a mixed reality headset that felt wearable, usable, and fixable, nearly a decade after they debuted in earnest. I'm obsessed with the fact that this battery pack is removable and hot swappable. How did it take this long? Batteries wear out, that's just chemistry. The battery cells themselves aren't immediately accessible, but they're only held in by standard Torx screws and light adhesive, a far cry from the Quest 3's nightmare of a buried battery. I also love the use of fabric as a flexible gasket for light leakage, not to mention the easily swappable faceplate and use of screws over glue. Aside from the battery, the best bit is this clever lens mechanism allowing for super adjustable focus. These kinds of adjustments make for a much more practical and long-lived headset. Now that's what I like to see. As exciting as it was to see a handheld gaming platform with the repair sensibilities of a PC, the Rogue Ally's modular parts, replaceable battery, and even swappable LED thumbstick rings weren't quite enough to cover for the rough software. Luckily, Sony's been working on handhelds for a long time, and following on their pro-grade DualSense Edge controller, they've created my number 1 most exciting teardown. The PlayStation Portal. The Portal is a phenomenal piece of hardware. The design sensibilities mesh a classic PlayStation controller with a central tablet, without sacrificing the repairability of a simpler form factor. Replaceable exterior panels, standard Phillips screws, and we knew we were onto something special. The thumbsticks are second only to the Edge's virtually tool-free stick replacement, and come out individually with only basic tools. If manufacturers continue to insist on using drifting potentiometers, modular sticks is the least they can do. The battery access could be a bit easier, but the last thing we expected was repair-friendly stretch adhesive, a great sign that Sony really does expect this device to be repaired. Add to that some modular ports, and it's enough to get this device into my good books. The bar is that low, folks. Hopefully our favorite hardware giants will be getting enough coal in their stockings to make them rethink their naughty list behavior. Happy Fixmas to all, and to all a replaceable battery. Good night.